All right, welcome back. Now, as we spoke about in the previous video tutorial, we had discussed some of the advantages of working with CSS, and we also discussed why it was more advantageous for us to do so than working with the really old and antiquated means of styling text in HTML, which was to use the font tag. And the font tag was always embedded inside of the body tag. So if I wanted to make this H1 be red, as we saw, font and closing font tag would be inside of the H1. All right, well, before we discuss and talk about how we're going to create CSS properly and to our best advantage inside of Dreamweaver, one of the things we have to understand is, well, why is it called cascading style sheets? And the reason it is called cascading style sheets is primarily because there are many different ways of defining a CSS style, and they have a hierarchical structure. In other words, what that means is one will take precedence over another, and so on and so forth. Well, as we can see here, we've got plain old default HTML. And what we have is a white background, black text on top of it. All right, fine. We've got a serif style font, and that may or may not be what you want to see. More than likely, you want to change this. So there's a couple of different ways to introduce CSS. Let me show you how. Well, first of all, we see that inside the body tag of my HTML document, I could actually introduce CSS right directly inside of this. And what does that mean exactly? Well, let me show you what I mean. First of all, if we go down in the properties window, you'll see that right now we are getting HTML information for this particular page. Great. But I could also switch to CSS information. All right, now if I were to, for example, just select the word lorem here, the first word, and targeted rule and say, listen, I want a new inline style. All right, well, let's discuss. What does inline mean? Inline is the first way that you can introduce CSS, and it is introduced usually here in the body section of your document. So for example, if I just simply come in here and say, I want this to be the color red, you'll see that in my preview, yes, it did turn red. And what do we get in our code? Well, we have our code littered with information. Well, it's not terribly littered, but there is extra information that, technically speaking, I don't really need. So what is this? This is just as good, or I should say just as bad, as doing it with the font tag. It introduces a span tag, which basically says between here and here, in other words, the word lorem, and then it introduces a style. Style equals color, and in this case, the color red, with this hexadecimal number. Well, as you can see, and as you might imagine, when I was discussing the, you know, inherent difficulties of working with the font tag, we can see all of those difficulties exist here as well. So the first way that you can introduce CSS is by using inline CSS. Is that a good way to do it? Wrong. It's a bad way to do it. So I'm going to select and remove those open and close span tags. We don't want that. That's not what we're going to do. All right, what's another way that we can introduce CSS? Well, here, if I say targeted rule, for example, and I will say new CSS rule. Okay, what do we want? Well, I could say make it the color red. And when you do that, it opens up this new CSS rule window, which we're going to learn about a little bit more as well. Well, if we were just to come in here and say tag, I want all my paragraphs to be red. Okay, in theory, this sounds all right, and I'm just going to click OK, but notice it says this document only. What does that mean? Well, this document only means, as you can see here in my code view, if I scroll up to where the head section is, here's the beginning of the head, here's the closing of the head. What did it introduce to us? Well, it introduced this information here. Now, it's better than the inline system that we had before, and this is called internal CSS. In other words, it's internal to this page. It belongs only to this page. What does that mean? Well, it's better than what we saw before because I don't have to add extra information in all of my paragraphs because I have quite a few in here. Basically, what it's saying, if I scroll through my design, you can see that it's turning all of my paragraphs red, and that's exactly what it does here. It basically indicates, look, any paragraphs on this page will be red. Sounds great. better than the previous version, but still not a great way to work with CSS. Why is that? Because if I had 100 pages, I would still have to open up each individual page one at a time, target the head section and the style tags, and come in here and change the color. That's a bit of a pain. As I mentioned last time, the best way to deal with CSS is using the third method, which what we call external CSS. In other words, create one external file that will rule all of my pages, right? The precious CSS file. So let's go about creating CSS and creating it properly. Incidentally, remember what I was mentioning to you about the three different ways of introducing CSS. We looked at number one, inline, which was in the body section. Number two, internal, which was in the head section. And number three, external, which is in the external CSS folder. That's the best way to do that. But do remember, CSS is called cascading style sheets because much like a waterfall cascades down, the same thing happens with the three different ways of writing CSS. Inline takes precedence over internal. Internal takes precedence over external. So you might be wondering, hey, sounds great. I mean, should I be using internal and inline to overwrite what's happening inside of my external CSS? You might think so, but you know what? There's still better ways of doing that, and we can do everything in an external fashion. The less extraneous code I have in my code page, right here, my HTML page, the better, specifically for search engines, right? It makes it easier for the search engine to get to the content that we want them to index. So that's what we need. External, still the best way. Incidentally, and of course, if there is no example of inline, internal, or external CSS, what does it give you? The default, which is what we see here. White background, black text on top of it. All right, with that said, let's now start by looking at working with external CSS. And we're going to do that when we come back in the next video.